Hello and welcome to this session in which we will discuss product cost versus period cost. This concept is important because every time a company incurs a cost, the company will have to decide whether that cost is expensed or whether that cost is treated as an asset. And when we treat it as an asset, the term for it is called capitalized. So we have to determine whether we capitalized an expenditure, we capitalized a cost, or we treat it as an asset. When we capitalize a cost, we say this is product cost. So product cost is basically when we treat an expenditure as an asset. And when we incur a cost that's not treated as an asset. Now, what is something treated as an asset? We treat something as an asset when we believe it's going to provide future benefit. This is the term. Well, if it doesn't provide future benefit or we cannot measure that future benefit, we expense it. And period cost is something that we are going to expense. So this concept, expenses versus capitalizing, is an important concept in accounting. Sometimes expensing called revenue expenditure. Sometimes they call it revenue expenditure to indicate that it's an expense, it's not an asset. So this concept is important by itself. In this session, we're going to be illustrating this concept by determining what do we consider a product cost, what do we consider a period cost. So whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate, I strongly suggest you take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com. I don't replace your CPA review course. I'm a useful addition. I can help you add points, 10 to 15 points to your CPA exam course. How? I can help you understand the material better. I go a little bit more in depth than your CPA review course. I don't assume any prior knowledge. And this is how I can help you understand your CPA review course better, which in turn help you do better on your CPA exam. Your risk is 1 month of subscription. Your potential gain is passing the exam. If not for anything, take a look at my website to find out how well or not well your university doing on the CPA exam. I do have resources for other college courses, such as managerial accounting, advanced accounting, governmental, intermediate auditing, so on and so forth. My CPA supplemental resources are aligned with your Becker, Roger, Gleam, Wiley. So it's very easy to go back and forth between my material and your CPA review course. My AI CPA questions are all out there. I have 1,500 approximately AI CPA previously released questions with detailed solution. So if you're studying for your exam, you want to make sure you go over those questions to see how they test you on the exam itself. If you have not connected with me on LinkedIn, please do so. Take a look at my LinkedIn recommendation. Like this recording, share it with others, connect with me on Instagram, Facebook, Twitter, and Reddit. So let's start talk about the product cost a little bit more in detail. Product cost are inventoryable cost. In other words, once we say this cost is a product cost, it means it's part of your inventory. In other words, it's an asset. It gets attached to the asset. Now, what happened to this asset? Eventually, this asset, we're going to sell this asset. We're not going to keep it forever. We're going to sell it. Once we sell it, it becomes cost of goods sold, which means it becomes an expense. So all assets eventually get expensed, but in due time. So what do we consider the product cost? Well, cost to bring in the asset to a saleable condition, it's going to be considered a product cost. Like what? Like purchasing the asset. You purchase something from Amazon for $100. Well, that's part of your cost. You paid $5 in shipping. That's $5. It gets added to your cost. And let's assume you paid 6% taxes. That's $6. That's $111. Let's assume you need special packaging for this product and you ask the shipper to package it in a special way, in a different package. Well, that's another $10. So you end up paying $121 for this product. So this is your cost. This is the cost of your inventory. Well, if this is your cost, it's considered an asset, assuming you're selling this inventory. You're in the business of buying and selling. But the cost would include the purchase, the shipping, the taxes, any processing. For a manufacturing company, their business is a little bit different. Manufacturing companies, what they do, they buy raw material, they hire labor, they put that product together, then they sell it. Well, for manufacturing companies, what's considered a product cost? Direct labor. Direct labor, we call it touch labor. It's when the person working on the product touches the product itself, working on it directly. Well, if that's the case, any payroll cost, it gets treated as an asset. It gets treated as part of the product. direct material. What's direct material? The raw material that we feed into the product. For example, if we're manufacturing a car, the tires, the radio, the seats, those are direct material. Those gets treated as an asset because they're part of the vehicle, part of the asset. The third category is called manufacturing overhead. And manufacturing overhead is any cost we incur in the production process other than direct material and direct labor. And this is a list of all other costs that we incur that has nothing to do with labor and material, direct labor and direct material, rent, depreciation, taxes, payroll. Oh, hold on. Didn't I say payroll is direct labor? Well, you could have payroll as direct labor. You could also have payroll as indirect labor. Well, guess what? Those people who are working on the line to manufacture the car, they need a supervisor. The supervisor is not touching the product, supervising the process. It's indirect material. You need a janitor in that facility. You need security guard. Those are all payroll expenses, payroll cost. And what we do with those payroll costs, because they are part of the production process, we're going to treat them as product cost. So any cost that helps you produce the product inside the manufacturing facility, within that manufacturing facility umbrella, it's considered production cost, which is, if it's a production, it's a product cost. So this is what product costs are. So period cost, then, it's cost that has nothing to do with the production. It's not directly related to the production or acquisition. So cost that we incur, that it's not part of the production process, it's not part of our purchasing the product, or not directly related, could be indirectly, but not directly. What do we do with these costs? Well, we expense them. And usually those costs are considered administrative and selling expenses. Let's start with selling expenses. So they're basically broken down under two categories most of the time. Selling expenses, cost incurred to sell the product. Like what? Like freight out. Hold on. This sounds like freight in. So notice we have a freight in and we have a freight out. Freight in was transportation to buy the product. Freight out, let's assume once you sell it, you're going to ship it on your own expense. You tell the customer, look, just buy the product, the shipping is on me. And you have to pay $3 per unit shipping. Well, this $3 is a shipping cost or freight out. Shipping cost is an expense. You already purchased the product or you already manufactured the product. So the cost for the product already done. Now you are incurring an operating cost to actually sell it. So freight out is an expense. Advertisement is an expense because we cannot measure the future benefit of advertisement. It doesn't fit the definition of an asset. We can't measure that. Salaries to sales team. Well, we're going to be paying salaries. Hold on a second. We have salaries to sales team and he said we're going to expense this as a selling expense. We have salaries that we pay to the janitor, to the supervisor, it's called indirect labor, and we have salaries that we pay to the direct labor, people that touch the product. So notice, when you pay the employees, you have to determine what type of salaries or payroll is this? Is this for direct labor? Is this for indirect labor? Both of these are product costs, or is this for selling expenses? You could also have rent. Well, hold on a second. We also have rent under product cost. Again, the same concept. You are renting something. You are renting a machinery. For what purpose? Is it for the production process? The rent is product cost. If it's not, it's a period cost. The same concept for depreciation. We could have depreciation as a period cost. We could have a depreciation as a product cost. It all depends on what are we depreciating. Well, let's assume we're depreciating a copier. Well, where is that copier located? What is it helping? Is it located in the production process? If it's located in the production process, helping the manufacturing facility produce the product, then it's a product cost. If that copier is part of the sales team, part of helping them make sales, then it's a period cost. So it all depends. Administrative cost is cost related to the company's operation as a whole. Like what? Like the salary of the CEO, the salary of the CFO. Well, hold on. Also, we here have payroll. Well, it depends what type of payroll. Well, this payroll has to do with the company overall, not related to selling, not related to the product directly. Well, nevertheless, although it's not related to selling, it's an expense because it's considered administrative. Administrative costs are expensed. HR salaries, payroll salaries, people that handle our payroll, all these are administrative expenses. Also, administrative expenses might have rent. They might have depreciation. Okay, they might also have a copier in that building where the CEO is located, and that copier is depreciated, but it's considered now administrative cost, not selling and not product cost. Interest cost, you need to know that interest cost is a form of financing. Interest cost is expensed. So interest cost incurred for repetitive inventory production. Okay, and the reason I'm saying here repetitive inventory production, because when we talk about product versus period, we're talking about inventory. Is the cost inventoryable or is the cost expensed? Interest cost, so if you borrow money to produce, to mass produce something, it's a finance cost. Finance cost is considered a period cost. A period cost is expensed. Unless the interest is to manufacture an asset for internal use, let's assume you are building your own equipment, then that's a different story. Or the asset, if you are building the asset as a discrete project for sale or lease, or someone asks you to build a ship or a plane or a missile or a house, and you are spending this money on the manufacturing process and you are incurring interest. The interest that you incur under those circumstances is considered a product cost. And this is the topic for a different, this is a topic for a different recording. Okay, basically we have to look at capitalized interest. So in a nutshell, you need to know the difference between your product cost and period cost. It's very important for your understanding of the accounting as well as CPA. At the end of this recording, I'm gonna invite you again to take a look at my website, farhatlectures.com, whether you are an accounting student or a CPA candidate. It will help you understand the material better. And I don't replace your CPA review course. You keep it. I'm a useful addition. Your risk is 1 month of subscription. Give it a try. Take a chance. You like it, you keep it. You don't like it, you cancel. That's it. That's your risk. But your potential gain is adding points to your exam, adding knowledge, adding resource that's going to help you put the CPA behind you and focus on your career. The CPA is a long-term plan, long-term investments. Invest in yourself. Once you pass it, you're done. You don't have to do it anymore. Good luck, study hard, and of course, stay safe.